Good morning, all of you. So today's class, we'll discuss about the mechanical power. So already we had the idea of the work done, the energy, different forms of energy. Today we'll focus on the mechanical power. So how, what is the basic thing? So like a power. So the symbol is what we usually use, like a P, that one. So first we'll go for the average power. So this is like a work done. Work done by time taken. So what is this average power? Like how we used to denote, no? P average, V average, P average. This will be work done by time taken, or delta T you write it. When it comes to the applications, the average power is very important. Instantaneous velocity is important. Average velocity may not be that important. But when it comes to the application, average power is important. Instantaneous power is of no use. Of course, we do discuss numericals, but when it comes to application, no, the instantaneous power, at that instant, what is the power dissipated? May not be useful. Average power is what matters. A good example, the electrical power. So there, the electric meter, what it reads, average power or instant power? Average power, no? At that instant, so what is the power consumed by all the electrical equipments is what instant power. Over a 1 month, what is the energy consumed? Energy over a 1 month, energy consumed by time taken. That will be the average power. So you take any machines, everything, no? The average power matters a lot. So we'll take some problems like how to calculate average power also. Then what is the necessity of the power has come? So whenever it machines come, no? Especially you see the water pump. So 1 HP motor, 2 HP motor. What is 1 HP? What is our 1 horsepower? That one. Since we need larger units, if you go for some machines, no, 1000 watt, 2000 watt will be the power of the machines. So to express that in smaller quantity, the horse is brought here. 1 horsepower, 746 watt. That's the only difference here. So if you look at the water pump, no, we express in terms of 1 HP, 2 HP, 3 HP, 5 HP. 1 horsepower. It's defined like this. Then what is the necessity of power has come? Already we have work done and energy. Why this power has come? So let's take one. So let me take the situation. So there is a person, is there? So he has to, he will climb steps and he has to place them a bricks each of how much? Say like a 1 kg. Like that, there are 5 bricks are there. Similarly, another person, okay, there's a person A, there's a person B. The same steps, the height of the stem, everything. Rough diagram I'm giving. So this is the height, say let it be, say like a 6 meter. We'll neglect the weight of its own weight, we'll neglect. Let's not bother effect, only the weight of the bricks will take it. So here again, these are the 5 bricks are there, where mass of the bricks is 1 kg. Then what is the work done by the both the persons to place all that 5 kg bricks at height 6 meter. So then what is the work done? We do write like this, no, phi into mgh. I'm asking you to neglect the effect of his own weight. So this should be equal to mass of the each brick is 1. So phi into mass of each brick is 1 kg, phi into 10 into 6. So this will be 5, 6, 30, 300 joules of work he'll do. What about the work done by the other person? He will also do same work, no? To see my, the person B also, I'll allot the work. But then he'll also does the same work in the, and he'll spend how much of energy he has to spend? 300 joules here. Neglect effect of weight of person. We are just neglecting the weight of person. Then the first person, let him take a time. Let him take a time, say like around 5 minutes, he will take it. And this person, he will take 2 minutes. So then can we analyze what about the power here? Average power of the first person should be WA by TA. So this will be 300 by five minutes. So 5 into 60. So shall we put this equal to 1 watt? And what is the average power of this person? WB by delta TB. 300 by 2 into 60. So 2.5 watt. Okay, now, okay, like who is having more power? The person B, no, is doing the same work in less time. So he said to have more power. So here for machine, is it work done by machine important or work done per unit time will become important for machine? Work done per unit time. So that's why if you go for civil construction, the labors, the power of labors matters a lot. You can't just pick up any labor here. So you definitely open the young people will be preferred. Any reason for young people? In a given time, they do more work. Suppose like this labor, what happened? He will charge per day 800 rupees. He will also charge per day 800 rupees. So tell me like from which labor, labor B, what happened? In a given day, will do more work, no? That's why you see the civil contractors, no? They are very intelligent. They will look at even the person's personality also when picking up the labor for this physical work. It's not that easy job. I'm telling this one. If you become civil engineer, no, you'll come to know that one. How to manage labor, how to take work. It's all very scientific things are involved here. And something which are where more energy has to be spent. There what happens, they will appoint the laborers who are physically strong, where the less amount of energy has to be spent. So there what happens, they will appoint the ladies or some little bit old persons, more than 40 years. So that's why the labor who are aged from 2018 to for less than 35, they'll demand more money. So like that, what happened when you construct any, go for civil constructions, no, all these matters here. This one, it's not that easy job. You have to manage all these things. The calculations should be done thoroughly of all this one. On and average, this person, how much of work you'll do and how much we have to pay. All this science is involved in that. So similarly, if the machine comes, even the machine also, no? So definitely you can say the, if suppose instead of person, let there be a machine. I think the machine B is better. In a less time, it did work. So definitely it must have more power. So what type of machines we prefer? The one which will give more power. More power in the sense, what happened? In a given time, it does more work. So what is 1 HP motor, 5 HP motor? 5 HP motor does more work in a given time. So that's why it is able to pump out more water. So depending upon the size of the tank, no, that particular, so you can say that like a power of the machine, what happened? The engines will be preferred here. So this is one basic idea, that one. So here, than work done. So what has become now very important? The power, no? The power, that one. So you look at the where all we use, especially in the running 100 meter race. So where the power becomes very important, no? Not the energy. So in that 10 seconds or 9 seconds, how much more you are able to do work based on that total pen, you'll have power. Based on that total pen, you'll have more running speed. So when you go for the biomechanics, no, there. So some of the sports, what happened, the power of an athlete matters a lot rather than what happened, the energy. So how much of power is able to generate matters a lot. Everyone is energetic, but who will generate power? You will win match. So like this, what happened, all things are involved here. So in advance, they may ask you very generalized questions of this kind. Very generalized questions also this kind, and some physics related and some math related. So three ways that they'll be asking you numerical. So you should be careful enough with these things. What should be the, I put watt, that one, W-A-T-T, watt, that would be power, and joule per second, 1 watt or the unit. Joule जोल पर सेकेंड और वैट. ओके आई विल राइट इट हियर, वन वैट और वन जोल पर सेकेंड. विद एसआई यूनिट व्हाट वी प्रिफर, द वैट दैट वे. No, the instantaneous power, we define it. The instantaneous power so we just write P, or if you want to write, you can take it the symbol P instantaneous. So this is defined as rate of change of work done. Rate of change of work done. So this is equal to dW by dt. dW is work done, not that unit. W is work done. Okay, fine. So this will be the expression for like a rate of change of work done, the instantaneous power. Now, what is the work done? Basic definition of work done. Work done equal to F bar dot S bar. So this will be F bar dot ds bar by dt. Ds bar by dt. S is what the displacement, so we can write it as F bar dot dot product of force and velocity vector, or instantaneous power equal to F V cos theta. What is theta? Angle between F bar and V bar. Theta is angle between F bar and V bar. Because all forces will not do work, no, only force. If a force acts perpendicular displacement, work done by zero. The similar thing with the power also. This is the basic idea of the instantaneous power. Okay, let's take some examples related to this one. So first thing, a block of mass M is kept on a smooth surface. At t equals zero, it is at rest. And I'll apply a constant power on it. Then what is the speed of the block after some time t, or what is the speed of the block after it covers some distance? So all that particular questions can be asked for you. So it is, the power will be continuously acting, and after some time t, what is the speed of the block? Okay, now constant, p is a constant. I'll put a condition, p is a constant. This is after some time t. So what is the distance covered by it? S. So I want expression for speed as a function of time or as a function of distance. So what is the basic definition? Look at what actually, if I say that a power P is acting, what does it mean? A force F is acting. If I say power P is acting, means nothing but how you have to manage this one. It is like a force F is acting. And because of force acting, it will accelerate. Due to acceleration, it will have velocity. So therefore, then this power, what we write, F into V. So further, what is F? F should be equal to MA. And further, A, what you can write, dV by dt. So this will be equal to P by M, dt equal to V dV. At t equals zero, what is the state of this? The block was at rest. And what is the, at any time t, let V be the velocity. So therefore, this will become Pt by M V square by 2. So V is equal to 2 Pt by M. This is the expression for speed as a function of time. Similarly, if I want the speed of particle as a function of the position, as a function of position. So here only let me put that one. So here F is equal to P equal to Fv. So what is F? F equal to M into A. Acceleration, I can write it as V dV by dS. So P by M dS is equal to V square dV. This is initially, what is the position? Let it be zero. Let it be at origin. So this will be PS by M V cube by 3. So what is the expression for speed now? Expression for speed will be 3 PS okay, it all depends upon like a speed as a function of position. What about here? Speed as a function of time. So when a constant power acts on a body, so just write power equal to F into V. Then what is F? The force you can write M into it. The acceleration as a function of time or a function of like a position, you can write this. Then you can express speed as a function of time or function of position. Okay, fine. So this is the So now, when power acting is a constant, so power what happened? Even it can vary as a function of time, the power acting on a body. Now this is at t equals 0. Let it be at rest. Or if you want, you can bring initial velocity. I'll give like this. So look at the power which is acting. Is a function of time. So by the time, after some time t, I'm asking you some parameters like the power. Expression for the velocity. At x equal to 0, it will be initially, and it will cover a distance s. Now again, what is the basic definition? Power equal to F into V. Power equal to P naught. P naught T square. What is F? F should be, I'll write one more step. F equal to MAV. So P naught T square M dV by dt. This one. Let me simplify this. P naught by M T square dt V dV. Let's put the limit. At t equals 0, initial velocity U. And at any time t, let V be the velocity of the block. So then simplifying this, this will become P naught T cube by 3M. Shall I write directly? Integral of T square T cube by 3. So this should be V square by 2 U V. So P naught T cube by 3M. This will be V square minus U square by 2. We wanted expression for V. So this should be 2 P naught T cube by 3M plus U square. Okay, this is the expression for the speed of the block at any time t. Now, what about the position? I think here I'm going to write m dv by ds. But you see this? Here there's a function of time is there, no? So if you want to, what happened, you can, you have v as a function of time, then this you write ds by dt, replace s there. You have to manage with mathematics here, nothing big. Now, what is the average power? Del it. Because there's the instantaneous power. What about the average power? I want average power. How to calculate average power? 0 to, in an interval of time, let it be capital T. So P instantaneous or P dt by 0 to dt. What is value? The P is P naught T square dt. Integral of dt, substituting upper and lower limit, will be this much. So this will be P naught T cube by 3 by t. So what is capital T? The interval of time. So tt, what capital T, what you can write? Interval of time. what the average power delivered by this applied force in an interval of time t. Okay, now can we know average power. Can we calculate the work done by this in an interval of time t? Because what is the basic idea of the average power? Average power, what we write? Work done by time taken in that interval of time t. The basic thing, no? So what is the average power? P naught t square by 3. So what is work done will be P average into t. So this should be P naught t cube by 3. So what is work done by this agent in an interval of time t, if they ask you? So directly what happened? You calculate the average power, and average power, you know, work done by the interval of time or the time taken, you'll get the work done. So they'll give power as a function of time. They'll ask you to calculate work done. Or directly you can calculate the average value. I think the same mathematics is what I'm just following, because what is a P average? dW by dt. Oh, sorry, P incident is dW by dt. P average is what? W by t, that one. So how to calculate average? This is a method. So here, what is the power? Power can be constant, can vary with the time. Sir, how do you produce such a power? How do that power as a function of time? I should make some mechanism, no, here. And if I say constant power, what do you mean by that? I think just a student has to analyze once. What do you mean by power constant? Means power constant means what you should analyze actually this one. So there's a block. I'll apply constant power. Constant power means nothing but what happened. We applied a force, and such that the product of force into velocity is constant. And what will happen to the speed? The speed will be varying with the time. Go back to the first problems, what we discussed, no? The first problems, what we discussed. The very first problem, what we discussed, no? The constant power, it's here, that check it now. So when you apply constant power, what will happen to the speed? Speed will vary with the time like this. So I should apply a constant force or variable force? A power acting on a body means a constant force is acting. I think not correct, no, it is. The product of force into velocity will be constant, but force will be variable. Just try to see, look at the mathematics here. Okay, this is about the power. If it is function of time, this one. Okay, now the power can vary with the distance covered. P as a function of P equal to P naught S square. Let me take initial velocity 0. Now what is the expression for speed, then average power, then what is work done? Let's see that. What all we can determine. So after some interval of time, it will be at a position S or indicate like this. The power is acting, it will acquire a speed v. This is at some time. Initially, it is at rest. I'm writing t equal to 0. Okay, let's see that one. So what is the basic definition? P equal to p naught s square. What is p? P equal to f into v. F equal to mav. What is a v dv by ds p naught s square? So further, this is m v square dvs equal to p naught s square. So look at this one now. M by p naught v square dv is equal to s square ds. At t equal to, at s equal 0, initial velocity 0, at any position, let it be v. So this simplification of this will be mp naught v cube by 3 s cube by 3. So what is the expression for v cube is equal to p naught by m s cube. So v is equal to p naught m So this expression for speed in terms of the position of particle or distance covered, anything you can write it as it is moving in one direction. Okay, look at now. This is a, so I want now the speed as a function of time. What you should do, write ds v equal to ds by dt, then so you get position as a function of time, then you can come back here. So some mass is involved already, you know, in variable acceleration. Similarly, what is the average power? Can we find out average power even if there's some not a function of time? Yes, there's nothing to do, like it should be with respect to time only the average is defined. So average power delivered by the agent acting on the block when it covers a distances. So let it be of this kind. So this should be, what is a p as a function of this? This will be as 0 to s, that one. So this will be p naught. P naught by s, this will be s cube by 3, 0 to s you substitute. So finally how much it will be? P naught s square by 3. This is the average power delivered by it. Now what is work done? So you can't write work done equal to P average equal to work done by distance. I think units will not match. Time parameter is needed. So how to calculate the time? Write V as ds by dt, you can bring the work done. Or simplest, shall I tell you one thing? What is work done? So what you should do to work done? Change in kinetic energy. Mv square by 2, initial 0 square by 2. M by 2. What is V square? V square will be P naught m 2 by 3 s square. It's okay, no? So try to maximum avoid mathematics in exams because you have to save time. So what you can do, alternative v as ds by dt, then s as a function of time you have to bring, then you have to introduce that time parameter. Instead that, what is the work done? Change in kinetic energy, no? What will be the situation? Power constant, power variable, power varying function of time, power as a function of distance covered, power as a function of speed again. What is the work done? Work done equal to change in kinetic energy. So there is nothing rule that work energy theorem is applicable only when this set of force acting. Any force work done by any force is equal to change in kinetic energy. That's what the work energy theorem tells, no? Whether it's an inertial, non-inertial frame, we are not bothered. In any frame, it is applicable. There's no limitation for the work energy theorem. What is the only condition? It is applicable only for particle. Why particle? Because when you apply force on any body, practically, we don't get perfect rigid bodies. What will happen to body? A part of that will be utilized for deformation of a body. So what all work done by force will not be converted into change in kinetic energy. A part is converted into potential energy of the body. That one. So therefore, a condition is put, work energy theorem is applicable only for particles. Of course, we are taking for granted in laws of, I did so many problems for the bodies, no? Wedge, block, everything. But sir, how come we assume that no change in the, no deformation of a body due to application of force, but practically the body will undergo deformation. Now, this is, I think, conceptual question. When they ask you, you should be very careful. Work energy theorem applicable only for particles. We are assuming perfect ideal bodies. That's why we are carrying on with the wedge block system. Okay, this is about the different types of forces when they act on a block or anything. No? So you can. So now next question comes. So some connected bodies. Connected bodies means here. Yeah. I'll take some constraint equation. You have some idea of constraint equation. No? Let me link the power with some constraint equation. See, multiple ways you're supposed to analyze. It's any arbitrary way they may ask you in exam. Exam is weekend or advance, anything. Take like this. So this is 3m, this is 2m. I'll apply power p. A constant power is applied at t equals 0. System is attached. Find the speed of the blocks a and b as a function of time. Can we extend that concept for one block? No, we started with one block. Can we really analyze, or it's not possible? I too don't know. I too don't know means just I'm asking you, like as a student, like is it applicable only for one block system? I applied a constant power P. Okay, this one, a constant power p is applied on the block A as shown. Find the speed of blocks at time t. Now first, what is the constraint equation? 3xb, 3vb equal to 2va. That's all. No? So there's a constraint equation. Already have come across this. There's a relation between the speeds. Change in length of this part of strings. So it should be equal to change in length of these two, no? This will be, so the change in length of these three strings will be corresponding for displacement of
2vb equal to 3vb.
Yes, sir, it is 2vb equals 3vb.
Okay, we'll do one thing. This is the I'm taking this one. Okay, this is some symbol. 2vb equal to 3va. Yeah. Change in length of this part of strings will be corresponding to displacement of block A. Change in length of these two corresponds to displacement of block B. Now, so when you apply power P, what are the forces that will be acting on the system? Nothing but we applied a power means, what does it mean? Okay, let's come for here. Okay, this is a diagram. So let's check all the things. Okay, so some of you still asking doubt. Okay, sir, how it has become. So what is the, this will be XB, XB, this is XA, this is XA, this is XA, no? So 3XA equal to 2XB. Differentiating that, we'll get the expression for that one. Even we can write for acceleration. So now when you apply this force, will there be any tension? Nothing but I applied a power means nothing but I'm applying some force. So here tension T will be acting. So this tension here 2t, this will be 2t. So velocity of the blocks, let this be Va, let this be Vb. How to break up, means how to analyze what actually going on. So power also, can we write like a P1 minus P2, means like a two powers are acting on a body, P1, P2, the net power, resultant power, P1 minus P2. Can we write like this? Say, what do you mean by power? Power means nothing but some force. Are you getting, no? It is like nothing but some force here, and there's a velocity. So F1 into V will be power. F2 into V will be the other power, that one. Able to make it out? I'm trying to generalize the situation. Okay, no. So let the velocity of the block, this will be, so what is the power? P minus 3t into speed of the block A should be equal to F into V you are going to write. No? So how to write this equation? Like earlier what we wrote, power equal to F into V. So the resultant power, what shall we write in this way? Tension set up by this. So there's a power P, external force, and there's a tension. So the resultant, what happened? F into V, we'll write it. So this will be minus 3T VA. Further F, what you can write? MAV. Time being. Yeah. This acceleration, what? You can write DVA by DT.
Sir, it should be 2M MVA.
2M, mass 2M. Okay, this one. So this you further simplify mathematically. This VA, P by VA minus 3T. This will integrate, we'll get the speed of the block as a function of time, but we don't know the tension. No, we should have some information of tension, or first of all, is this equation what we generated is correct? So this is some sort of like external force. Power means, say, like some force force into velocity is what they'll be acting different. A constant power is what I applied it. So we end up this one. But again, the T is something what? Tension, what we assumed it. Okay, come to the right hand side. We'll see that. Just a discussion type. Nobody will ask you anything. Just a discussion type here. So what is it? Like a 2T power acting. So can we divide this power as nothing to do? No. Here, what is a 2T is equal to? So 2T should be equal to acceleration of the block 3m into AB. This you are going to write dv by dt. So this will be 2 by so here we don't know this tension, is it a constant or it will also vary with the time, because the force which is acting, how it will be. Goodness, so this tension, will it be a constant? Definitely, I should say no, that one. The tension is also a function of time. If that is available, then we can manage here. That's why I see we don't have any much numericals related to like this. Hardly any book is there. Only when you refer some higher mechanical engineering books, no, that they need. What is the nature of force? What you apply? If you know it, then you can predict the tension. Then from there you can manage it here. They may test you with some questions of these kind. They'll not ask mathematics, a constant power x, what can be the tension, the string. In fact, it'll be variable. It all depends upon the power, how we define that. Constant power is how we define it. Again, it depends on that one. Okay, this hardly we have any discussion in the books. I just gave a general idea. Okay, come for. Now, is it only, sir, who will set up that power? Means, just we are discussing that power. Now, which all forces can generate a power? Next question. So I'm going to explore things now. Okay, spring force, can it generate a power? Conservative force can generate a power is what the first thing. So I am beginning like this here. So this is a spring block system. What is our next discussion? Power generated by the various types of forces. So first I'll begin with a simple spring force because already you have enough idea of spring, no? This is the equilibrium or natural length of the spring. Now the spring is elongated by how much? A distance x naught and a release from rest here. The block is pulled by distance x naught, so the spring will get elongated. So spring force will act and it is released from rest. That's what the question is telling. Release from rest. Now the spring force does positive work and it's a conservative force. So when the displacement of the block is at a distance x here, if x is instant deflection of the spring from its natural length, is it okay? Fine, the diagram and how much of spring force kx will be acting. And according to the idea, what we know, the force into the velocity will be the instantaneous power. So first, how to get that v? Conservation of mechanical energy, kx naught square by 2 should be equal to kx square plus mv square. So what is the expression for v? V should be equal to instantaneous power generated. This 2 will get eliminated, so this should be.
So the spring has been compressed.
No problem, compressed or elongated, no problem. Instantaneous deflection of spring. Deflection means, what do you mean by deflection?
No, sir, in the first case, it's not elongated, it's compressed.
It doesn't matter, no? Elongation, compression doesn't matter. I can take it, no problem. You have to shift this block here. That's the only thing, that one. So I think problem doesn't make much a difference. Only thing is the block should come here in this position. The block should be here, somewhere here. If I release it, then it'll come somewhere here. Diagram a little bit congested. That's why I just made elongation. If you want, I'll change this word. Okay. No, the instantaneous power developed here. So this should be equal to how much? This is the speed of the block. Then what is the instantaneous power generated by the spring? P equal to spring force into speed. Spring force kx into v. So definitely, I think option A will not come into picture. See how we define instantaneous power? We should not define instantaneous work is a meaningless quantity. I think you have to be very careful. Instantaneous power defined, average power defined, work done work done is what? Force into displacement. No, the displacement to occur, what happened? There some finite interval of time should occur that one. So therefore, instantaneous work is not at not all defined here. See, work done is defined for an event, not at that instant. So instantaneous work is quite meaningless. We don't have any such physical quantity. So you have to be careful in exam. This is about the power. So instant power develop. Okay, we can't pick up the option A. Now he's asking the maximum power. So can we differentiate this? dP by dx is equal to. So I'll differentiate this. I'll equate to zero. Then I'll check at what position the power will be the maximum. Can you manage this mathematics? How to calculate that maximum power? Differentiate this given equation with respect to x, equate to zero. Then you'll get the position at x equal to certain value in terms of x naught. There the power will be maximum. Why is bringing the idea of maximum power? Means either maximum power occurs. Tell me where do power generated by spring at extreme, zero or non-zero? Power generated by spring on the block at extreme, zero or non-zero? Zero, no? It mean, don't repeat again, started, don't repeat. Power generated at extreme will be zero by spring on the block. Power generated by spring at mean position on the block will be zero. Because here what happened? The spring force will be zero at mean position. The spring force will be zero here. Clear this? Here the spring force will be zero, maximum velocity. So power generated by spring on the block at mean position will be zero. Power generated by the spring on the block at extreme will be zero. And somewhere it will be, it keeps on increases, becomes maximum, then decreases. So when a block, when a spring block system, there in a spring block system as the block oscillates, the power exerted by the spring on the block, constant or variable, it varies. That's why the word maximum he has brought it. If it were constant, no, I would have not brought that maximum.
Sir, why is it zero at maximum elongation, sir?
Velocity is zero, no, at extreme point.
Okay, sir.
At extreme point, velocity is zero. At mean point, force is zero. So therefore, the power delivered by the spring on the block at extreme and mean will be zero. And okay, as it moves, tell me like a, see like a, this spring is what giving energy to the block, no? So the rate of change of kinetic energy of block, shall I say, equal to the power generated by the spring? Can I correlate the words? Rate of change of kinetic energy. The rate of change of kinetic energy of the block should be equal to the rate at which potential energy decreases. Both are same. Or power generated by the spring force. So what is this system? The elastic potential energy is getting converted into kinetic energy. With time, we are linking this one here. So don't call elastic power. Instantaneous power developed in spring. We should not use word again, elastic power. Nothing to like a, the rate at which potential energy decreases, that is getting converted into increase in kinetic energy of the block. So there's energy conversion occurs in over an interval of time. Therefore, the idea of the power has come. Anybody value maximum, where the power will be maximum? At what position? Differentiate this and equate to zero.
So I got none of the above, sir.
No. Check calculations once. At what position the power of the spring will be maximum? That position is asking in terms of x, in terms of x naught should be there.
Sir, is it option C?
I'm like a, you have to confirm. I'm not sure. By calculation, you're supposed to tell, no? not by looking at the, and we just calculate tablet and tell it.
Sir, I got x is equal to root over of 3k² by 4m into x square, sir. All inside the
room. Where will get an option, sir?
Option?
C, sir.
Option C. At this position, the power generated by the spring will be maximum. Okay, this one. So this value of x, you substitute, you'll get the maximum power. Where the rate of transfer of energy by the spring to the block will be maximum. Another sense of expressing. Where the transfer of rate at which the energy gets transferred by the from the spring to the block will be maximum at x equal to x naught by 2. This is a meaning. There's a transfer of energy occurs from the spring to the block as it moves from extreme to mean. Where it will be maximum? At this position. There's a meaning of that. Okay, I think P max, you have to check it. P max. Is it option B is what you have to check it. Huh? Do calculation later on. Huh? Just only math one, no? No, some simple question again. A body of mass accelerates from rest to V1 in time t, the instant power delivered to the body as a function of time t. Initially, this is a test. After some time, accelerates uniformly from rest to V1. So, accelerates uniformly means what you can write. V1 should be equal to AT1. And what is the instantaneous power? F into V or MAV. The initial power delivered to the body as a function of time t. Write it here. So what is A should be equal to V1 T1, shall we write? And V equal to what? Further AT. I'll write one more step. What is A equal to? V1 T1. You have to be very careful for in objectives. Huh? They will trouble you with some symbol form things like the instantaneous power delivered to the body as a function of time t. So you should not write power equal to f into v1. At time t, what is the power generated? At time t, what is the velocity of the block? At time t, what is the velocity of the block? Velocity of the block should be equal to at at an instant of time t. And what is that acceleration? The acceleration information I'll reveal from here. Some symbolic form questions will be there. You have to be very careful. It's all about the interpretation of symbols. What is t1 and what is t? You should be very careful. No much big concept is involved. Okay, no, some. This is some general question. So you must have some basic idea of the engine. An engine with constant power output drives a car. When the car approaches a hill, the driver shifts the gear to high gear to low gear. The driver does this. So when you shift the gear from high gear to low gear, from say like from 450 is called as high gear, no? 192 are called as the low gear, that one. Now tell me why we should do that. So in which gear the car will move with high speed? At high gears, 4-5 will be high speed, 1-2 will be low speed, no? So option B is totally ruled out. Car will move with high speed. High high gear. We'll have high speed. That one? Are you getting this? There's a basic condition. Then, next again, why do we shift that one? So if you look at the basically a car, front wheels, front and rear wheels. There are two types of engines what will have. The front wheel driven and the back wheel driven. If the engine is front wheel driven, if the engine is, so like a, where do we apply? So the engine, what happened, will apply a torque or a force. The engine can generate only a torque, that one. So here a torque is applied here. This torque, what will happen, will make the point of contact to slip, and because of that the friction, the friction, what will happen, the point of contact will try to move backward, the friction here will act forward, and this friction acting forward, what it does, it will try to push the block, will try to pull the car. So there, here what happened, the back wheel should rotate. So the friction here at the back wheel will be acting this one. If it is a front wheel driven. So the two types of cars, what happened, usually you'll get front wheel driven and rear wheel driven. Try to see this is what happens here. Okay, now what is the basic necessity when the car approaches the hill, the driver shift the high gear to low gear, the driver does this. When you go for low gear, there the push force will increase here, force pushing the car forward, this friction will be increased. How the push force? So definitely what happened, if I go for low gear, no, less speed. Less speed means less torque. Because of less torque here, what happened, the friction force will increase here. Because of friction force, now it can climb up. So definitely what happened to speed? Speed will be decreasing that one. So here, to increase the speed of the car, this is ruled out. To increase the force pushing the car forward altogether. So you have to pick up this one. So this is the one basic background. So, but you are not showing the force. Definitely, if you climbing up the hill and if it at low gear, no, definitely you can see that F1 will be greater than this F2. And when you are moving on normal road, no, the difference in F1 minus F2 will be less compared to when it's climbing up hill at the low gear. So when we get into rotation mechanics, so there you can see very clearly, like a car driven. So like a front wheel driven car and a rear wheel driven car. So it all depends. Suppose you take the Volvo buses, no? All they are the rear wheel driven. And if you go for the Tata Indian company, no? They're all the front wheel driven. questions can be of like this also. You have to be careful. Now some... the torque, if it decreases there, the alpha will decrease. And because of the decrease in torque, the rotational, so as the torque decreases here. So you know this, if you take a body here, if you apply a torque acting on your body. So here what will happen? Say friction F will act, no? Friction will F will act, and we are going to write A1, this alpha 1. So what is F equal to? MA1. Then what about the torque? Torque minus F1 equal to M I into alpha 1. And for pure rolling, A should be equal to, A1 should be equal to R alpha 1. Okay, to maintain that acceleration constant, so like here, if I shift for low gear, the torque will decrease here. So here we write F1 equal to torque minus I alpha 1. I'm just giving only wheel, but inside the mechanism will be such that the friction will increase between the wheel and the ground. So according to this equation, F1 is equal to what? Torque minus I alpha 1. Sir, you say that low gear, less torque. Okay, torque is there here. So then the friction, what will happen? Should decrease. Friction decreases, then it cannot climb up the hill. The friction must increase here. Your torque decreases, the impact of that, what will do? It will decrease alpha. So the resultant of this will be such that it will be more. So therefore the push force will be more that one. Okay, I don't think so. The diagram what I given with this, you should analyze here. The basic mechanism should be that one. So to for low gear, what happened? More push force can come. So don't analyze using this diagram. Huh? And this is about the electric pump one. So this is the, I think, motor pump. It has to lift water. From a well. So what is the depth? The depth of this is given. D is given. So it has to lift the water from a depth and it should project with a velocity V. For that, what is water that this pump should do? It should do work, no? MGH. Then it should project with a speed V. So it should lift the water to a height H. Then it should project with a speed V. So, but here some power is involved, no? So what to do with power? So I'll differentiate dW by dt. This is the power lambda gh. This is lambda v square by 2. What is the lambda? The rate at which the pump draws the water. That was the lambda. Dm by dt, you can see the cubic meter per second. So what should be the lambda? Lambda should be equal to 2. So this is what? 2 meter cube per second. GH we know all. So substituting will get. But he is asking now something. If the power consumption of the pump is given by. Why that efficiency also he brought? So what is efficiency? This is what the power what happened is needed, no? And for that what happened? Power. Okay, we'll define that. This is power supplied. This much of power supplied to this and this much of power, what happened? It generates. So therefore, what is the power supplied? Now we can do one thing. If the power consumption of the pump is given by power consumption is telling. So I think this is, let me write here like this. So what is the power consumption? Equal to power generated by the efficiency. What is this P? This P should be power generated. Because why do this 80% is brought 0.8? So here the reason is some losses will be there. No, there'll be some friction. Even the pump itself will have some moving mechanical parts. There'll be viscous drag. There'll be friction between them. So therefore the efficiency will put around the 80%. So this is the total power what it consumes. In which open, this is what the useful power. What is this useful power? This is what you can say power supplied to the pump. Like this, what happened? Will differentiate distinction. This is what useful for us, no? It is lifting from height and it is projecting the water with a speed V. This is what useful power. This is what we supplied. So how much power we supplied, is it all utilized? No. A part is lost. Where do this remaining part has gone? The 20%. It is used to overcome the friction between the moving mechanical parts of the pump, or there'll be friction like between the water and the pipe. So for that purpose, it'll be utilized. So when we go for viscous diagnosis, there will analyze some problems related to this loss in power. Are you getting no? So here is asking about the work done by the pump to lift water at a height H and project that water with a speed V. This is the thing. So differentiate this. The dm by dt is what? The rate. So what do you expect? No, this lambda, if you want more water to come out per second, tell me what you should increase here. You should increase power. No, if you go for 5 HP motor, what happened? More amount of water you can pump per second. This was the correlation between them. So how the PP is directly related to lambda. If you want to pump out more water in a less time, the power of the pump should be more. Try to correlate things. This is some very generalized question. I'll apply power P, is telling. So what is the horizontal by an agent delivering constant power P? So there the friction is also there. Friction X, and this is mg sine theta. It's asking find the maximum speed of the block during the course of ascent. So this power is what? F into E, and nothing but the power rate actually means there is a force, and that force is what balancing these two. So therefore this should be equal to mg sine theta plus F. What is asking maximum speed? No, I think we should not correlate like this. This will be some, you will cancel out. So what you're getting, F equal to mg sine theta. That's all here. So instead directly you do one thing. So definitely the force which is there as the speed is constant means what happened? We applied a force, the applied force into speed of the block is what? The power. So that applied force, what it should balance mg sine theta and the friction. So therefore, in place of F, I'll write it. No, some very important terms are there.
Sir, why are you taking it is moving with constant velocity, sir?
You try any other alternative. So let me write, I applied a force F. There's only maximum speed possible, no? There's only maximum speed possible. I'm taking care of this speed only. Now, tell me like this external power, no? Tell me what happened this external power. This was the power supplied to the block. What is the mechanical power dissipated? F into V, frictional force into velocity, mechanical power dissipated. Are you getting this one? So now what is the efficiency of this system, if I ask you? What you should write? Is it all the energy supplied to the block? Is it converted into useful energy? No, this work done to overcome friction is lost as heat, no? It is permanently lost here. So where is useful? Only the rise in potential G. Yes, it got converted into increasing potential G. So therefore, what is the efficiency of this system? Greater than 100 or less than 100. So definitely less than 100. They may test with this. This is what we supply. This P is acting with some exchange agent is pulling the block. E is supplying energy to the block. So what is the efficiency of this system means? What you should write? Mg sin theta into V divided by P. P is a given for us. And what is V? V is this one. So what is the efficiency of system? This should be equal to Mg sin theta into V by P. So what is V by P? V by P will be, so Mg sin theta by Mg sin theta plus mu Mg cos theta. So therefore this will be sin theta if I send below, tan theta plus mu. Getting this one? This is what power supplied. This is what is P. This is the power supplied. And this is what useful power available. This friction into velocity is not useful power. It's a mechanical power dissipated. So how you have to interpret? Mechanical power dissipated. That is what? Mu mg cos theta into. You have to be very careful about the terms here. Dissipated. What do you mean dissipated? Permittivity lost as heat. See, sir, why can't be mg sin theta into V as mechanical power dissipated? Again, if I stop applying this power, again, what happened? The mg sin theta does work, no? And the gravitational potential energy can be converted back to kinetic energy, to some other useful form, where the friction can't do like that. Work done by the friction, what happened? Lost as heat, oh no? Again, we don't get back, no? So therefore, dissipation word is brought here. In every problem, try to think about the mechanical. So what we say, mechanical efficiency of system, or this system, how much is able to convert the given power into useful power. What is useful power? Mg sin theta into V is useful power. In every numerical, try to think about the useful power also, or the efficiency of the system. One more. This is a block. Try to see the conditions given. I apply force. So what is the force? The force is a function of time. That one, this is a block where it is kept on rough surface. So when we apply this force, the block is initially the power P developed by force at T equal to T2 is approximately some kilowatt is telling. Given mass of the block mu and the value of K constant, not spring constant, K is given, and also the time. So the force what is applied on the pulley is a function of time. I'll give some 3 minutes time. Okay, let's go for the friction. Here, when you apply this force F, let's start the problem. When you apply this force F, here, how much of resultant force? 2F. clear this. So then any friction will act. Yes, there'll be friction. So very, for just for t greater than zero, the block starts moving. The answer may, no, you have to put may. Why may? Because when the block will shift, when the applied force 2F is greater than the limiting friction. So what is FL? FL is equal to mu mg. Value of mu 0.4 m20 into 10. So what is the limiting friction? What we have? 80 Newton. So for the applied force to become 80 Newton, what is the time it will take? So value of K is how much? 40. Value of K is what? 40. So let's do one thing. 40 T square. And 2F force is acting. Shall I say after 1 second for T less than between time interval 0 to 1 second, what is the state of block? Block will be at rest, no? So when the block will start moving, only after t greater than 1 second. For less than 1 second, the block will be at rest. Will I agree? Because the applied force will be less than limiting friction. The 2F will be less than limiting friction. Then once t becomes greater than 1 second, then the block will accelerate. So then we write down the equation 2F minus F is equal to M into A. So this will be 2K T square. FL is 80 Newton. 28 dv by dt. This will be 2k. KK is how much? 40, no? So this will become 80 t minus 80 equal to 20. So this will be 40 minus 4 is equal to 8. Okay, now solve this. So what is dv is equal to 4 t dt 4 dt. What should be the is asking? Look at the question. The power developed by the force at t equal to t2 is approximately, so for that we need, what is the velocity of the block? No, so here I'll put it 0 v. What should be the limit? What should be the limit I should take? 0 to 3 seconds or 1 to 3 seconds? 1 to 3 seconds, no? When the speed of the block, the block starts moving after 1 second only. The limit should be 1 to 3, not 0 to 3 here. So solving this, B equal to 4 t square by 2. So this will be anybody value? Speed of the block. Anybody value? T square 3 3. Okay, no, some yeah. 80 by 3. This will be the, at t equal to 3 seconds, this will be the speed of the block. So what actually now is asking, what is the power generated by applied force? So where that power is on the cable? There's a cable, no? How to calculate that? Let me draw that small one diagram, rough diagram. Look at this one, no?
Sir, speed is 8, velocity is 8.
How much? 8, huh?
Yes, sir.
Oh, somebody said 80. Only 8 meter per second, huh? Okay, fine. I know. What is the state of the block? Block is having velocity V. He's asking power generated by this force acting on the cable. Now, what if the speed of this point will be 2V, no? Am I right? Constant equation. So therefore, what is the power? Power should be F into 2V. Say this, you have to be very careful about the some terms here. Power generated by the force on the cable. On the cable, how much like force into what is the velocity of this point P, that one? 2V, no? If the block moves with the velocity V, the pulley what happened will move by, the pulley will move by V, and the this particular point A will have a displacement, or say if block is having displacement X, the point will have displacement 2X. So therefore the power generated should be F into 2V, that one.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, there it's 80 T square, right?
Yes, sir, it's
80 T square minus 80 is equal to 20 A.
80 T square, huh? What is the force?
K is equal to 40, right?
Okay, I'll just check it. K equal to 40 T square. Okay, here, yeah, T square. I think no things will change. T cube by 3. Okay, I'll make correction. So this is 4. I think that this value also will change. Do calculation. I think this will be. Somebody earlier one, somebody said this. This should be the velocity multiply. So some 19.2 kilowatt. Check the answer. It'll come this much. Let's come for.
Sir, in the previous question, why did we take 2F to be less than FL, sir? Why did you keep that condition?
Here,
Yes, sir, here.
For this time,
Okay, sir.
For this time. Come for this. A person, a triangular wedge of mass m. Read the question. There's a block. Read the question. It's like a person running on a plank, or similar to that already what you had idea. That is what your top line. Let me take this as M2. The person here. Mass of the person, and this surface is smooth. Anyway, this should be rough, then only can walk, no? And its velocity with respect to the wedges you want. He's asking us to analyze the situation. We know some basic things like what action the friction should act on the person. The resultant friction, like this, and on the wedge, that UR is constant. what action the wedge will move. What action the wedge should move, left or right?
Right.
The wedge will move like this. The displacement of wedge will be towards right. Now we'll and whatever the normal contact here, and it is like this.
Sir, it would be left, no, sir.
No, right, ma, right. It will be right.
Why, sir?
Like a similar to person walking on a plank. The frictional force will make it. So your component of friction will make it. Will the component of friction will shift the wedge towards right? Yeah.
But there's the component of normal reaction also. No,
the normal reaction has come because the person starts walking. So is there is in this system. As he starts walking, no, this F will be more than N. Check it. And this F is a static.
Sir. Sir, but F should be less than N. Because mu is less than 1.
I don't know why you are thinking all unnecessary things here. The simple idea is this F is what? First of all, let's check that one. This, what is this friction? Static or kinetic?
Static.
Okay, fine. So if there's static friction and is moving with a constant speed, no? So therefore, we'll balance the weight of the person, M1g sine theta. Will balance M1g sin theta, the friction acting. So very first thing, the friction acting on the person, the friction force acting on man is Mg sin theta only. I'll pick up this option. Option B.
Sir, but how did you say the wedge is moving towards right, sir?
Wait. You have to allow teacher to speak little bit. I had to explain, no? I can't do magic directly. Let me explain all the ideas. The person is moving with a constant speed. So what is this? F is a static friction, F equal to M1g sin theta. And you see that all the velocities are constant. So what is N? N should be equal to what? Mg cos theta. N should be equal to Mg cos theta, M1g cos theta. This is vertical direction. Along normal direction. Okay, now let's go for this particular thing. So component of F, how much you get? F cos theta. What is F? F equal to M1g, this one. So here, component of friction along x-axis, how much it will be? F cos theta. Then you are going to say M1g sin theta cos theta towards right. This one. Component of normal reaction, you check it. N equal to M1g cos theta. Then here, M1g, so like M1g cos theta sin theta. So if you look at these two forces, in fact, they're equal, no? Now tell me like here, what is this N? And look at this N, what will happen? So component of friction will also act here. Of course, there is no friction here, so this component friction doesn't matter. So look at this N. N is some sort of reaction. No? The person is able to press hard the inclined plane because of friction. So this N is some sort of reaction and this F is action. And we have done many problems in laws of motion where the normal contact will be less than applied force. Go back to the basics, what you have learned. Tell me, what is the normal contact that is acting between the blocks here? Will it be less than F or greater than F? Less than F, no? The same role plays here. Okay, no? So this is about the option B, as moving with a constant speed. Okay, let's come for the velocity of the thing. So how the person is moving. So what is the velocity of the wedge? So I'll resolve the velocity of wedge into two directions. One, perpendicular to incline, other, parallel to incline. So this velocity, how much it will be? This is theta, so V2 sin theta. What about this? V2 cos theta. Now the person will be in contact with the wedge, no? When he's in motion. So therefore, what should be the relative motion of the person with respect to wedge along the incline? Should be zero. Then what is the velocity of the wedge perpendicular to incline? That should be the velocity of the person. Because how is the velocity of person with respect to wedge along the incline? So therefore, what is the velocity of person with respect to ground perpendicular to incline? Should be V2 sin theta. So I'll come for option A. I'll start from here. The velocity of person with respect to ground perpendicular to incline is how much? V2 sin theta. Because there is no relative motion. Because what is another reason? Because normal contact is non-zero. Is in contact, no? Constraint equation, better say constraint equation. Sir, why you are writing velocity of the person perpendicular to incline V2 sin theta? Constraint equation. Velocity along the common normal must be equal when the normal contact is non-zero and they're moving with a uniform velocity. And then what is the work done by power due to normal contact? I think option A we are in option A. Power due to normal contact on the man. This should be equal to how much? N into V2 sin theta. Okay, so in fact, it'll be non-zero. You check it. Next, after this, velocity of power due to friction on man is, I'll come for option C. Power due to friction on man. I should be negative or positive first of all. I think we have discussed previously in exam one problem, can a person walking on a plank?
Positive.
And he is not with respect to wedge, he's saying. He's not saying with respect to wedge, with respect to power due to friction on man is zero. So shall I pick up this? Or it should be non-zero. Now for this, what is needed? We needed velocity of the person with respect to ground along the incline. How to calculate that? We know velocity of person with respect to incline, and we know velocity of the incline, V2 cos theta. I'll go for relative velocity concept. U R plus velocity of the man along the incline. I think I can write some. Shall I write X and Y symbols here? Take like this, X and Y. So they should be velocity of man along X minus velocity of the inclined plane along the incline, this one. This should be minus of minus. Upward, I'm taking up the incline, I'm taking positive. This should be equal to how much? Plus V2 cos theta. So this will be UR minus V2 cos theta. This is the velocity of man with respect to ground along the incline. And what is the power by the friction? What should be the power by the friction? So power by the friction on the man should be equal to how much? F into VMX. I think it's a non-zero, no? Cannot be zero. With respect to incline, it should be zero. Because the foot what happened will not have any displacement at that instant, static friction is acting. With respect to ground, it should be non-zero. and it's power due to normal contact force on the wedges. How the displacement of wedge towards right and how the normal contact is acting towards left. I think it's a non-zero, no? And it should be negative, not positive. It should be equal to N into V2 cos of 90 plus theta, am I right? Because N is acting like this. This is velocity of the wedge. There's a normal contact force acting on the wedge. This is theta. This is theta. Sorry, this is theta. Take like this. What is the angle between normal contact and acting on the wedge and the velocity of the wedge? 90 plus theta. So will it be positive? It will be negative, no? Just some good problem to analyze, thinking in different things. The velocity of man with respect to ground, there's a different way I'm trying it, because this will be easiest method to analyze the problem, because it's a theoretical question. He didn't ask numerical. So you should really search for alternative method. And just took help of the basic constraint equation, because the person is in contact with the inclined plane. So therefore, the velocity along common normal must be equal. Go back to laws of motion. That is what I applied here. You can do by other thing. Find out the velocity of person with respect to ground. Find the velocity of the wedge. Then resolve velocity of the person perpendicular incline. It will kill your time. Always search for any other alternatives available. Okay, no. This is some very good application question I'm bringing. A constant horizontal external force acts on the wedge block system so that no relative motion occurs between the blocks and wedge. Find the average power applied by the external force on the system in an interval of time T naught. At T equals the system is at rest, all surfaces are smooth. This is a block. See, if you just see the book, no, you have more the mass-based questions, like initially in the first part I discussed. So try to be alert in advance. Definitely the mass-based questions, they will try to avoid. Okay, this is the overall. M. This is a string. See, the preparation for JE Advance is what like a teacher should discuss more different methods. Then what happens? You'll be in a little bit comfortable position. You'll get a confident. Then with that confidence, what happens? You can manage exams. Then once you start getting marks, what happens? You feel like as you know many things, then you start thinking creatively. Okay, get this one. Then you'll enter into IT. Since you have confidence, then there some changes will come and gradually you'll become a super engineer. There's one alternative method is what in our education system available. Anybody can grow in science. It's not that something intellectual only. Probably you should follow that particular thing, that one. So if a teacher, because at your level, I feel like you should permit teacher to introduce you more ideas. Then you multiply that ideas. Once you come revision program, I'll not disturb you. In revision program, I'll give assignment. I'll ask you to think on this. Okay, no, there is something is telling no relative motion between the blocks. Is it possible blocks cannot move? Yes, no, I'll apply force. There's the external force. Then because of this, the wedge will accelerate and is telling there is no relative motion. So all the wedge, everything will have same acceleration. Then with respect to in the wedge frame, if you do this problem in the wedge frame, a pseudo force will act, ME. Then the tension is balanced by pseudo force, here tension, here this tension. Then the pseudo force on the block, this 2MA. This pseudo force will press the block 2M, and because of that, we'll get a normal contact, call N1, and on the wedge, it will be N1. 7MG is N2, here N3. Okay, all these are the resultant forces acting. Then what is the net external force acting on the system? It's only the applied force. If you see in the ground frame, there's only force which is acting on the system. Remaining all will become internal, no? This tension, this will become internal. Here the tension and this normal N1, N1. So remaining all will become internal. So therefore, you do one thing, break up individually if you want. F external, what force acting on the pulley is also acting on the wedge, T minus N1 equal to 7M into A. Then, what is N1? This is what in the ground frame you are writing. In the wedge frame, what when you are standing on the wedge, then you say that the pseudo force will balance the tension. And again, in the ground frame, what is one more equation you write? T minus 2mg equal to 0. Then one more equation here, N1 minus 2m equals 0. So these are the set of equations you write it. Or directly in the ground frame, you can write equation. What is the only force acting on the system? Applied force. Mass of the system, 10m. Let it into acceleration. So how to calculate that acceleration, or substitute all the values T, substitute this N1. So T should be equal to MA you substitute, and N1 equal to 2MA. So then F external, so this equation 1, 2, 3. Put 2, 3 in 1. Equal to MA minus 2MA equal to 7MA. But we don't know this external force itself. No, it didn't give that force itself. So how to bring that power? Okay, let's take help of this tension. Let me equate equation 2 and 4. From 2 and 4, MA minus 2MG. So what is the acceleration equal to? 2G. So substituting this, the equation 5, the equation 6. Put 6 in 5. So F external is equal to 10M. Acceleration is how much? 2G. So how much it is? 20MG is what external force that is being applied. He's asking to calculate the, find the average power applied by the external force on the system in an interval of time T naught. Initially, the system is at rest. And the moment I apply force, the value of force is such that the blocks will be at rest related to wedge. This is the overall condition. So therefore, what is the velocity acquired by it? Don't disturb somebody. Somebody mute it. Please mute it. Chaitanya Agarwal, please mute it. Okay, no. So this is the expression for what is the velocity of this should be equal to A by velocity equal to AT, we'll write in velocity, speed of the block, because constant acceleration, so this will become 2GT. So then what is the expression for power? Power is equal to F external into V. So 20 mg into V. So what is V equal to? 2GT. Then further proceeding, this will be 40 If you want value of G also, you can substitute here. So this is the expression for the instant power. What is the average power? P dt. Interval of time he has given T naught. So this will be 0 to dt, that one. So take this much. So this you substitute here, 40 mg square t dt, 0 to t naught. Integral of dt will be t, substituting upper limit t naught, we'll get this one. So this simplification of this will be 40 mg square. So what is the average power? G square, I think 20 it will come. 20 mg square t naught. This average power delivered by it in this one. So what is work done by the external force? Means change in kinetic energy in that interval of time. So already I told you like how to get the work done, another alternative method. So like this, you can, they can bring some system. They can bring some a wedge block system. They may ask you about the some sort of powers one. So you have to be very careful. In books open, we have maximum everything about the some power is acting, power as a function of time, power as a function of distance, constant power, etc. But these are the real problems what you may encounter, and you have to be careful. So just it's a, I took help of the laws of motion ideas. The blocks will not move with respect to wedge. So therefore, we'll balance the weight, we'll balance this 2 mg, the tension. Then as the blocks will move with the wedge, means we'll balance this tension, the pseudo force. So therefore this acceleration should be equal to 2g. The acceleration of the system should be equal to 2g. That is. So then get expression for the force acting, because he didn't say it, what is the force. If I said force, we would have matter, no? So that force first we have to calculate. That one. So we got expression for force here. Then what is the power? Power equal to external force acting into the velocity of the system. Then rest all mathematics. From here again mathematics. Power as a function of time, I have to calculate average power in interval of time 0 to t naught. Some words, no, mechanical power dissipated. So shall I say that power experience, or the power generated, or power like a power, power acting by the friction. What is the frictional force? So, like if you see this one, no? We write like this. Frictional force or pending, can it generate power, or it should be always a dissipative power? Because whenever friction comes, so friction always does negative work. Will you justify? Friction always does need, no, it can do positive work on also. Friction can generate power also. Though it's a dissipative power, it can generate. Because we took examples where the friction was doing negative work. So therefore we just call it as a dissipative power. It may not know. You take some block up in a block, you apply force on the lower block. Who will move the upper block? The friction only does positive work. So if a friction does positive work, it will generate power. If friction does negative work, it will dissipate power. So again, don't make the friction will always like a lead to a dissipative power. The option will be wrong. because friction can do positive or negative work. Same thing, also friction can generate positive, friction can generate power or can dissipate power. I think in when ask any theoretical questions, you have to be careful with these words. Okay, fine. So tomorrow we'll discuss some small concept in that equilibrium, mass-based one, and we'll go for vertical circular motion, some application problems, different application problems. We'll try to work out tomorrow that one. Okay, thank you, all of you. Okay, thank you, all of you. Take care. Bye. See you. I'll end up the class.